And I sure do hope that you feel, that you feel. Hey guys, I'm gonna do a 7-week pregnancy symptom update thingy mabob with you today. Kind of like a day behind, but I just couldn't pull it together yesterday. We have Kaya here. She's right there. She's playing on my table. She just woke up from a nap. So yeah, she's right there. So if you see a foot or hear a noise, that's who's doing that. So so basically same stuff as last week has been happening and going on. I'm still extremely tired. I still get nauseous. I still get nauseous. I'm still nauseous all day, every day, basically. And I have to remember to eat. I'm kind of turning into like a mini vegetarian because the meat, I don't want to smell it. I don't want to look at it. I don't want to touch it. And sometimes I crave certain things that have meat in it, like tacos, but my stomach, and I made tacos the other day, but my stomach just can't handle it right now. So it's really important for me to just like fruits and vegetables, side dishes like macaroni and cheese, mashed potatoes, anything light my body can handle. Anything heavy, it's kind of like not taking, it's making me feel sick. But then again, I feel sick almost with everything I eat. So my sleeping is still kind of messed up, but hopefully I look forward to that getting better. One thing about that is getting up in the middle of the night to use the restroom now is kind of frustrating even more, because I have I'm dehydrated. By the time I get up, I'm so thirsty that I have to use the bathroom and then I get some water. But the fact that I have nothing on my stomach, for if you have had nothing to eat, I drink water on an empty stomach, it just makes me feel so sick. I just want to throw up. So it kind of sucks because I have to drink something because I'm thirsty. But my stomach is empty, I can't. It's like my body's like trying to reject it, but I'm not going to eat at 3:00 in the morning because I'm not hungry. I just want to drink some water and go back to sleep. So usually I find myself just drinking the water anyway and laying down and just like, I'm tired, too tired to care right now. And I'm just going to go to sleep anyway. So basically that's what I've been doing. I've been kind of moody lately too. I kind of, been like real snappy at the kids, like, do this, do that right now. So I've been trying to, relax a little bit because I don't want to stress out the babies either. But it's just really frustrating because I feel like everything is just like frustrating me and irritating me. But it's okay. I get irritated really easily anyway. But I guess now with the hormones, it's just like I'm ready to like some people. Even people like in public, I'm just like, dude, don't mess with me because I'm just not in the mood. It's probably all over my face when I'm out, but I'm like, just don't mess with me because you don't want to see go down today. But other than that, and the meat kind of aversion, I really just don't want that. Other than that, that's really basically it for me for symptoms for this week. Basically the same. I do want to add a little side note. I need to move because we're just in a condo and I have nowhere to fit the twins, and they'll probably just be in the closet somewhere because I have no room for them. So I went to go look at a house today, which is gorgeous. I love it. It's right by my house. It's so perfect. The owners are really strict. They're not really strict. I'm just saying they're going to do like extensive everything. And, and there's a couple of other people that want to, that want it also. So I'm kind of like in a race to see who gets it first, who has the best credit, who has the best job, to see who's going to get it. But anyway, hopefully, fingers crossed, guys. Yeah. I'm praying I get that house. I love it. It's a 3-bedroom, 2-bath, and it it has like an upstairs, downstairs. It has a dining room, and it has a bonus room attached to it, which is like a family room. It has a huge fenced backyard for the kids to play in. It's got a, even downstairs, it's got one bedroom, but there's another room that he calls an office, but because it doesn't have a window or a closet, you can't legally call it a room. But honey, you could use that as a room, especially for one of the kids, you know? So, that's like basically a 4-bedroom house to me. And then there's a bathroom downstairs and another huge family room. So, I am in love with a house right now. So I think I'll know by tonight if I got it. If not, I'll just keep looking. But either way, we're going to move because I want the twins to have their own nursery. And I'm excited for them to have that. So I've picked out what type of bumper. It's like a breathable bumper. And it's really cute because it has like ribbons all around it. So, and they have boy version, girl version, and like unisex colors, basically. And they're just like white, and the ribbons are the color, have color. I'll insert a picture here. That's the thing that I'm talking about. And so I can't wait to find out the sex of them so I can order. Some of the things that I probably will get before I find out the sex are their crib, because it'll probably be the exact same kind as Kaya's, which I need to do a review on because people have been asking me if she can fit in there still, or, you know, they're worried about getting that because they're worried that their baby's not going to fit after they get bigger. But she's 7 months and she still has a lot more room left in a mini crib. So mini cribs are, don't sleep on those. Those are good investments. Plus, it utilizes your space. Even if your baby has their own room, you know, eventually they're going to be like her age where they want to crawl and play, and then they'll have more room, or you can add like more furniture in there or something. Anyway, so I'm excited about the house. That's where I went today. That's why I kind of did something with myself, because I've been in sweats for every other day this week. But yeah, and I go back to work next week, so we'll see how that works out with this nausea and stuff. We're going to hit it again. Hi. And so I'm going to let you guys go, but I wanted to kind of give you a little update on what's been happening with me this week. Not a lot has changed, a lot of funkiness. I'm kind of feeling sick right now. I probably should eat. And then, yeah, so stop, Kaya. She's getting crazy. But anyway, yeah, so, and I'll give you guys an update on if I get the house or not. And if I do get it, then we'll probably be moving within actually a week or so, pretty fast. So we'll see. And I'll talk to you guys next time. Bye. Say bye, Kaya. Say bye-bye.